A lot of things have been said about Dr. William Tunga, and we don't like tribalism in this country, and I also don't like tribalism, but the tribe which I come from is known for using big words. So when I speak about Attorney General Emeritus, or something, they're not retired Attorney General, not former Attorney General, not I mean, that was what's in them, Waco. So we don't want to say retired Chief Justice, former Chief Justice, we don't say former Prime Minister. So we'll just say, you know, Chief Justice Emeritus. The eyes have it. No more former Chief Justice. At least, a few weeks ago, not a few, a few days ago, Boniface, Reverend Joya, and Devin D and myself were honored and humbled, actually, to receive an award from Sauti ya Wanjiku, basically for, you know, and this award was very touching to me and a little scary and humbling to say, because last year it was awarded for the first time to only one person, the Chief Justice Emeritus now. And here we were, four people. They needed four people to get the head. Not awarded against one people, one person last year. So Chief Justice, Reverend Mzito Zanda. This man has paid the price. He's lived life in exile, which our generation don't have to, as we think about human rights. He's a man whose intellect is combined with a sense of action. In short, a life of purpose. He's a man who leaves a legacy of reform, simplicity. If you ask, what would Jesus do? You think about William Tunga thinking about the interests of Kenyans and what would Jesus do? And he wouldn't become corrupted and join the forces that are easily and powerfully influential in this country to corrupt. William Tunga, your sense of dignity, moral courage, your patriotism inspires myself and other leaders in the parliament we have today. We have moved human rights from the streets and from exile and from theory and from hidden hideouts to the real corridors of power, so to speak. On behalf of myself and members of the Kenya Parliamentary Human Rights Association, there are other members of parliament here, colleagues like yourself who experienced exile under the Moi era, Honorable Munuva next to you there. You really inspire us, and we know it's our time to take this battle and fight for justice in parliament, and the lessons that have been shared and mentioned. Patience. We will have to have that patience, because change and the dream of a Kenya of constitutionalism and human rights for everyone will take a time to achieve, but we won't relent, and you are the path you have set and the example you have set will serve as well. So Godspeed in all your endeavors. I'm MP for Kibra. I know you can't split yourself into two. The people of Korogosha have already stolen your heart. I will make up and spend some time in Kibra. We have good things there. But if not, there is a good artist from that side of town, Giuliani. How many people know Giuliani? So I'll finish off by saying, and join me if you can. Nikonja tasiezi karanga, owe ae shagala bagala. Niko tayari kulipa gharama, sitasimama maovu ya kitawala. Sitasimama maovu ya kitawala. Ufisadi, ubinafsi, ukabila, kuuza sura, wataki kuuza sera. Niko tayari kulipa gharama, sitasimama maovu ya kitawala. Sitasimama maovu ya kitawala. Yoshonas, uko tayari kulipa gharama, utasimama maovu ya kitawala. It's a challenge and an invitation to us to also make sure hatutasimama maovu ya kitawala. Tuwe tayari kulipa gharama. God bless you.